best that can happen, right?
Catch it on fire and you die.
From right here, you can smell it. It smells like kettle corn. You ever had kettle corn?
I was just gonna ask you that. I don't know.
You've all heard about somebody getting sugar in the gas tank, and you probably know that it screws up a car, but what in the heck does it do? Does it make the gas a solid and screw everything up? Does it turn it into some kind of weird goop? Let's try something where we know what'll happen. We're gonna dissolve sugar in water. Wow!
That's right, we're doing this stuff again. Wouldn't it be great if that magic had also gotten me a magic stirring straw?
Wow.
What? Great! Look, it's almost gone.
Sugar is actually tiny little crystals. The molecules of sugar are attracted to each other, and they form tight little lattices. When those crystals are surrounded by water, the water attracts the surface sugar molecules and surrounds them, and then it's dissolved. Slowly, it grabs more and more of those tiny sugar molecules, gets rid of the crystal lattice, and they're suspended in the water. Ah, bees love sugar! So water is polar. What that means is that molecules have a slightly different charge at one end than on the other. Here's what it looks like. These two hydrogens, H2O, are slightly positive. And this O is slightly negative, neutral-ish, but because of this energy, molecules of water can attract other polar molecules. And sugar is slightly polar. Wait a minute. You mean to tell me that sugar responds to an electric charge? Yeah, watch this. Oh, yep, look at that.
Wow.
Felipe, how's your hair? Pretty dry? You got a dry scalp? Let me prestato that hair of yours.
That's very relaxed.
Oh yeah, that's it.
Oh, there you go.
So because it can respond to a charge, the crystalline structure can be disrupted by the polar water molecules and it can squeeze between them, loosely dissolved in polar water. And that's how things dissolve, like salts and minerals. And that's why your body works. Now, what happens with gas?
It's water,
and then that's gas floating on top. The water we just determined was polar. Gasoline is nonpolar. It's got long chains of hydrocarbons that don't have different charges on different ends. So the energy of a polar water can do nothing to really pull them apart, even if I shake it. What's that? Oh. Eddie has a thing about water fires with Siddhar.
An ocean fire.
Eddie's deathly afraid of ocean fires. And he wants me to tell you this is how ocean fires happen. Sugar, as we just demonstrated, is polar. So gasoline's non-polar. Sugar is polar. What do you think's gonna happen when we mix the sugar in gasoline? Eddie, what do you think will happen?
It's gonna catch on fire.
So, gasoline. Whew. I'm getting a headache. It just f-ing explodes. Sugar. Gasoline. Stirring it. Nothing. Just sits there at the bottom. Because the sugar is polar, gasoline's nonpolar, it doesn't dissolve. See? It's just sugar. Putting sugar in a gas tank is kind of the equivalent of putting sand in a gas tank. It's just gonna sit at the bottom. If you're lucky, it's not gonna make it up to the engine. You're just gonna need a new fuel filter. Gotta drop the tank. So what's so special about sugar? I don't know. I don't know where that started. We should do a wheelhouse on it. Maybe finally a wheelhouse on car-related topics. I'm just kidding. I really like that show. So we're gonna put this in a truck, and we're gonna run it, and we're gonna see what happens. Wait, you never see a guy fill up a tank of gas before? Jeez. It feels wrong. Doesn't this feel wrong?
James, what do you think's gonna happen? Well, I've heard for my whole life that it'll ruin the engine, it'll gunk up and like clog up all the lines and stuff. But in our research, we found that maybe that might be a myth. I hope it
It's crazy that your ex-wife drives a Gucci truck.
One thing we found out that for sure
is it's not easy.
It's not a thing where you can just like sneak up to your enemy's like house and like quickly fill it full of sugar because it gets stuck in the fill tube and then you have to flush it out. So if you're gonna sabotage somebody's vehicle, bring some extra gas to flush it. Pro sabotage tip from your friends at Donut.
Might help. topic at all?
Oh yeah. Oh, definitely.
Moment of sweet, sweet fear. Figure we'll let him run for around 10 minutes.
Bad news, guys. Check engine lights on.
It smelled weird.
Yeah, but who knows? I have a feeling this engine just smells weird.
I know, but it doesn't smell like weird.
Exhaust, right? Yeah. It smells like a burny thing. You could drive for quite a while and not even know somebody
sabotaged your ride. I smell kettle corn. I do, I smell kettle corn. From right here, you can smell it. It smells like kettle corn. Have you ever had kettle corn?
I was just gonna ask you that. I don't know if I smell it.
Try to start it again.
Starting it up!
It smells like caramel corn back here, which means the sugar is burning through the engine and it's going through and coming all the way out the exhaust.
Yeah, we're just gonna run it until it don't. Most of the sugar is just sitting at the bottom of the tank right now. It can't get dissolved in the gas. I'm surprised it hasn't clogged the filter, but that also means not a lot's getting pulled up. I think mostly this is smoking because it's a piece of crap. We've run this thing for over an hour with sugar in the tank. We're just gonna pull it out of the throttle and we're gonna let her die. It's not even dying. What are we doing, guys? Sugar in the tank. Look at this. Ah! So we think that, yeah, some sugar crystals might have gotten in there and burnt when it got sucked up into the engine, just from the way things smelled and the way things smoked. But by the end of the hour, it was just idling like we hadn't done anything to it. Even going into this thinking that the sugar wouldn't do too much, I'm impressed with actually how little it did to the engine. Now most of that sugar is probably just sitting back there in the tank. Seems like sugar in the tank's a pretty sweet experiment. Yeah! So, sugar in the gas tank? It sucks! But it's actually more like sand in there than some Frankensteinian goop. It will probably do some damage. You're gonna have to drop the tank, probably get a new pump. But hopefully it's not the end of the world. And thanks to Honey for sponsoring this video. You know, when you buy stuff online, you always get to the checkout and you see the box, it says discount code, and it's sitting there empty, staring at you like the abyss. So you go search for codes. And by the time that you find one that works, it's tomorrow. Well, Honey does all that for you. It's super easy to install. It's literally 2 clicks and it's free. Honey has found Science Garage fans an average of $34.35. They told us that. That's a lot of money on average. Searching for codes yourself is usually fruitless or takes all this math. Honey does all that math for you, so it makes sure you're getting the best deal you can. And that means more money for my money collection. And if it doesn't find a coupon code, it's because there isn't one. Which means you can shop knowing you're getting the best deal. Listen, there's no reason not to use Honey for everything you buy online. It's free to use, installs in just 2 clicks. Get Honey for free at joinhoney.com/sciencegarage. That's joinhoney.com/sciencegarage. Like the video. I want to see how many likes we can get on it. Please like me so I don't get fired. Oh, we got a new show. Check out a new episode of a new show. Check out this episode of Wheelhouse. Follow us on Twitter and Instagram at Donut Media. Follow me at BidsBardo. You like this shirt, guys? You can go get some apparel at shop.donut.media. Sugar in the Tank was one of your ideas. Let us know what you want us to do an episode on. We want to hear from you in the comments. Don't tell my wife why we're out of sugar.